the scene in the St. Thomas post-game huddle following a double overtime victory over Linfield. Joining me in studio tonight, the head coach Glenn Caruso and linebacker Tommy Becker. That's the coach, that's Tommy, just in case you were wondering. What a win, coach. You're still playing in December. MIAC is well represented with Bethel. Talk about that in a minute. But you had to get through yesterday and the emotion that goes with that. We saw it in 30 seconds, but that's a whole lot more than that.
It's a good life we're living right now. And I think the guys have worked tirelessly to put themselves in this situation. We're fortunate enough that we're 12-0, so we got a high seed. We have home field throughout, playing in front of our family and our fans, and it's produced some results right now. So yesterday was a wonderful step in the process, but I think it's important that we understand it's just a step.
Tommy, I was mentioning to you earlier, you get the double whammy weekend. Your alma mater, Wayzata, wins the state championship. We'll have a little bit more on that a little bit later. And then you come out and beat Linfield. That's a pretty good football weekend.
Yeah, it's fun. It's fun to be a part of those things.
What has this year been like for you as it's built? Because you had to win an overtime against St. John's, the Bethel game. A lot of things have had to go right, including that double overtime yesterday.
Refreshing. You know, a lot of hard work went into the season, and you know, it's just good to see good fortunes come.
It's interesting, too, Coach, because you've had a lot of near misses in the last few years. A lot of the same games that you won this year went against you in years past. You do feel like things kind of even out sometimes if you keep working at it.
Yeah, and trite to say, but all part of the process. I mean, we understand that if we wanted to go from where we were to where we are now and where we hope to be in years to come, that you have to learn how to win some of those games. And we've been here 3 years, and in the five games that we've lost in those 3 years, they've all been really close. And what I love about our kids is we talk a lot about mental toughness, and you may lose a game or a situation, but they never lose that twice. They never lose a lesson. They always learn and move forward. And we're not perfect. We don't pretend to be. We strive for excellence. When we don't hit it, well, we try and figure out why we didn't, and always make the best out of a poor situation. I think our guys do that.
I mentioned it. You had to work to get here tonight. That win yesterday,
yeah, oh yeah,
it wasn't easy. Linfield came in on that cold turf over in St. Paul, and it was chilly, and you did just enough to get the job done, and you made plays when you had to make plays.
Well, we were blessed with some beautiful Minnesota weather, and I could not be more happy about it. Colin Tobin opens up the scoring here with a one-yard shot, and our offensive line's really doing a nice job. But this right here is really who we've been. We're a pressure defense. We play a lot of zone coverage behind it, but Harry Patera making a very nice play. And Dakota Tracy's been the wild card. He's a guy who can kind of do it all, a point guard guy who can hand the ball off, bootleg a little bit, and throw when necessary. And Dakota's a Southern Minnesota product. And here you'll see Colin go around the edge one more time and hops in for the final touchdown in regulation.
Here comes Fritzy, though. This is your playmaker.
And you know
league.
What? I mean, Fritz, we all know that he does a fantastic job, but a lot of people don't understand. These guys have thrown for hours and hours and hours in the offseason. They live in the same house. They think the same. They do everything the same, and probably a lot of that success is in the offseason.
Now, that was to go ahead 24-17. You forced this fumble to end the game. And if they score, you might have another overtime.
No question. And you love the hustle. Willie Barigi, Holy Angels product, and Chinny OG, local product as well. I mean, guys that are there just hustling to get it. Willie ends up getting the fumble, but it was forced by Brady Irvin, another local guy, a lot of local guys, obviously, and great celebration at the end. That's just fun to watch those clips.
You mentioned Brady Irvin. He went to Eden Prairie High School, then to Iowa State, and transferred in. Tommy Becker from Wayzata High School to the University of Minnesota. Then, Tommy, you decided to transfer to St. Thomas. Was that a difficult decision, and as you look back now, does it fall into the category of everything happens for a reason and it all worked out?
I believe so, but you know, hard work paid off with that as well, and you know, I'm just fortunate to be part of such a great team, and you know, things didn't work out for me in Minnesota, but you know, I'm happy now.
How is it different? You know, I think one thing people don't understand is they think, well, it's a lot less intense, you're still working really hard, putting a lot of hours into football if you're going to be good at it at Division III or any level.
Oh, definitely. You know, I dedicated myself this summer to football, working out and getting teammates. And it's not surprising me, you know, guys like Willie Barigi ended up with a fumble because, you know, he was working out with me all, you know, hustling all summer. And, you know, guys like Zach Sturm and the Brian Villar, Tony Dana, you know, they really dedicated themselves this year. You know, we got a taste last year, and this year we just wanted to work harder and really accomplish all our goals.
How much fun have you had since you headed over to St. Paul?
Oh, so much fun. You know, it's just fun to, you know, love football again and be a part of a big family and, you know, have the camaraderie that we do.
And now a very interesting rematch. You don't see this very often where two conference teams play each other this deep into the playoffs. you know, everybody talks about St. John's over the last 50 years for good reason. But over the last 20 years, Bethel has been right there every year, contending for a title, winning some titles, some memorable games. And you had a memorable one with them during the season. You won 10-6.
We did, and they have a fantastic team. I think their coaching staff does an unbelievable job, and they get players to play hard for them. And we've been here 3 years now, and we've been fortunate enough to end up on the positive side of that. But every single one of those games have been knockdown, drag-out battles. And that's why we love playing that team, is we look forward to those games because it's real football, and they play a hard-nosed style of defense, and they run the ball. And the first game here, you'll see it right here. You'll see Dakota hand the ball off to Colin Tobin going for a touchdown that puts us ahead in the fourth quarter. And that it was fairly close.
It was
a one-score game. And there's Coach Johnson. Steve does an unbelievable job. I think he's a tremendous leader of young men, and I think he coaches a very good team. And, you know, as I've said, I look forward to our battles. Our team looks so forward to those battles all year long, and we are absolutely blessed to now have two opportunities in the same year. Should be a great one. Come on out.
Steve loves to compete, and that's what makes this so much fun, as he's done it for so many years. Tommy, they love to play defense. You guys love to play defense. How concerned do you get about weather fronts this time of year? Do you think about that at all, playing this outdoor football?
Not concerned at all. I hope it gets colder and colder.
You like that?
Yeah.
Why, because it hurts more when you hit somebody?
That's right. Football's a tough man's game.
Yeah.
You know?
You'd like to see a little snow and a little sleet, wouldn't you? That wouldn't bother you at all.
I was disappointed that last week of the season when we were fortunate to get the bye week, and I woke up and it was just a blizzard outside.
Yeah, that piece of tape that we had was Bethel playing Augsburg in the snow. You had your bye week the final week of the season, so you actually skated through because it was actually pretty nice until that point.
It was, yeah. We were very fortunate with the weather.
Do you guys talk at all now about national championship? What do we got?
You know, we just stay focused, work on each day. You know, we're fighting to stay together one more day, and you know, we're just fortunate enough to have practice yesterday, you know, the day after day, and then we'll get back to work on Tuesday. And, you know, just I just love being around these guys.
It's going to be interesting to see, Coach, maybe this will be some weather-related, but how many fans will be on hand on Saturday, because that's a lot of alumni from both
teams. It was packed last time, hopefully more now.
Gentlemen, thank you very much. Good luck. Congratulations on a great season so far, and we'll see you out there on Saturday.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Tommy Becker, Glenn Caruso. Still to come on Rosen Sports Sunday.